Okay, guys, I am so excited about this. Bloons City Battles, the rules of the arena. Leave a like, because this game is so awesome and will be awesome. Okay, let's watch this. Rules of the arena. Rules of the arena.
So first up, we'll start with one of the main changes that you'll notice off the bat. Medallions are no more.
We've stripped medallions. No more medallions.
There's a competitive progression system based on trophies, which will be earned and lost when you win or lose a match. And trophy count is what will be used for player matchmaking. These new trophies will also be how you progress through the arenas. Once you hit a certain number of trophies, you move on to the next arena. But be careful, as you can drop back if you fall below the trophy threshold.
Wow!
A rat game will earn you one trophy, and you'll receive an additional trophy if you're on a win streak of 3 games or more. Moving up into a new arena will also award you one extra trophy, and losing a match will result in a loss of one trophy. And perhaps most importantly for the game's skill-based matchmaking system, winning games or arena promotions are the only ways to earn trophies. They cannot be purchased.
Oh my goodness, guys, this is so great.
Trophies and enter the elusive Hall of Masters.
Hall of Masters.
And matchmaking will be done using a dynamic Elo ladder system. And this is where you'll join the leaderboard and battle out to be number one and earn those sweet, sweet badges.
Wow.
The season is planned to last 6 weeks, at the end of which you'll receive a badge based on the highest arena you achieve or where you placed on the Hall of Masters leaderboard. So we've talked a little bit about how you match with other players and how you progress through the
game. Come on, guys, this is so great.
Each player's loadout will consist of one hero and 3 other towers of their choosing. In-game, you'll only have access to the standard tower boost powers from Battles 1.
So great.
Each player will have 3 uses. Bloons sends have also been overhauled to a more user-friendly and intuitive system. Unlike Battles 1, where all Bloons sends remained available throughout a game once they were unlocked, the Bloons you can send now change as the game progresses. So early game rushes will be replaced with Eco Builders, mid-game finishers, and big Moab threats. Camo, regen, and fortified modifiers will also be available to beef up those bloom rushes. And finally,
come on, guys, this is so great.
If the player has won by that point, the player with the most lives will win. If the game is tied, both players will be reduced to 1 life and sudden death will commence for 10 rounds. At round 50, all eco will be set to 0 and cannot be increased above that. All cash collectibles, money banks, etc. will be auto-collected and then disabled, and the only way to get more money will be to sell towers in an attempt to land that killer blow.
Okay, this is great, guys. I really enjoy.
The game continues until one player loses or there's no balloons left on screen.
Oh, there can be a draw system, guys.
So there you have it. These are the rules of the arena for Battles 2, and we hope this has got you just as excited as we are to get the game in your hands. If you enjoyed this video, then please support it with a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and as always, all our social links will be down below if you want to keep up to date with the latest.
That's all.